Good day, viewers. Welcome to another episode of the Catfish Farm Enterprise. Here at the Catfish Farm Enterprise, we help educate catfish farmers on how to run a successful catfish farm business and make profit at the end. Everyone that is venturing into a business wants to make profit at the end of the business, but adequate knowledge is required to make profit on the business, not to acquire losses. A lot of persons are into the catfish farm business today. They are not making profit out of the business. Some are acquiring losses. Some are also making profit, but not as they should. So here at the Catfish Farm Enterprise, we help to guide farmers on how to set up the business, to run it successfully, make profit at the end. So we have dropped various videos on how to start up the business, things to consider on pond construction. And a lot of persons have been asking, okay, how much should I have before I venture into the catfish farm business? What and what is required? How much money is required? So we are going to be asking that question today. You're going to be looking at the cost estimate and the profit in the catfish farm business. What are the cost estimate in starting up the catfish farm business? So if you're new to the channel, hit on the subscribe button, turn on the notification. You're going to be dropping more videos that can guide you on how to run a successful catfish farm business from the scratch. You might be someone that has no idea about the business but want to venture into the business. We are here for you to guide you properly. So we are looking at a cost estimate in feeding. Now, in starting up the catfish farm business, there are a lot of expenditure you're going to be making, ranging from pond construction, ranging from the nets you are going to be buying, also the cost of feeding, the amount in buying your fingerling or the juvenile, depending on the size you want to start up with, and also some logistics costs like transportation and maybe some other costs that can come up in time being of training the catfish. Now, as I have said earlier in some of our videos, now feeding accounts for the bulk of the money in the catfish farm business. You spend more in feeding. So we are looking at the cost of feeding. Now, to make profit from any business, a knowledge of the amount of money required in feeding is essential. So I know how much I should set aside to feed my catfish. So now we are going to be looking at the cost of feeding 1,000 juvenile. Now, for new farmers that want to venture into the catfish farm business, my advice is that you start with a maximum of 1,000 juvenile. Now, you might have enough money to buy 10,000, 20,000 or more. Now, for the knowledge sake, at least a maximum of 1,000 for the first stage to start up, and you can maybe scale up your number as time goes on, but at least the 1,000 is a good start, then you can scale up. For very small scale farmers, 500 is still good. But today we are looking at the cost of feeding for 1,000 juvenile. How much am I required to have to feed 1,000 juvenile from the juvenile stage and up to maybe an average of 1.5 kg? Now, the figures we are going to be giving out in these videos might not represent the market value in the, maybe in the next 3 months. Now, due to inflation and the cost of maybe feed might increase over time, and also the prices of the sell packaging might increase over some time. So, but this is a guide that you can work with, and over time you should understand the amount they sell the feed per time and how much they sell packaging per time. It now determines how much you sell and how you buy. So we are going to be looking at the cost of feeding 1,000 juvenile from the juvenile stage and up to the market stage. So you're doing a breakdown on how much I will spend on feeding. Now note the other expenditures in the catfish farm business, like your pond, your net. All these expenditures are done once. After you've completed your pond, you're not doing it again. So an existing farmer, you spend money only on feeding, getting your juvenile and feeding them. So you're looking at how much am I going to spend in getting my juvenile and feeding 1,000 juveniles. So stay tuned as we do the breakdown guide. We are looking at the estimated cost of feeding, estimated cost of feeding 1,000 juveniles and the profit margin. So how much will it take you to feed 1,000 juvenile and the profit 1,000 juvenile and the profit margin you get after feeding them? So that's what we are going to be looking today. We are going to be doing a breakdown on this. Now, one thing you should note that when buying your juvenile 1,000, some of the farmers will want to give you maybe an extra 100. Now, this is to help you out, because once they start growing, some won't grow well, some might die at the process of growing, some they might be eating off through cannibalism, and some other stuff might happen. So the 1,000 you are buying, you at the end you might not get up to the 1,000. But one thing you should bear in mind is that the amount of feed you give to your fishes is the equivalent of the weight you will get per time. Now, we'll be taking this example, and also note that a bag of feed contains 15 kg of the feed. 15 kg for one bag. So the amount of feed you give to the fishes will reflect eventually in their weight. So we are going to be looking at a breakdown for the estimated cost of feeding and the profit margin you get at the end. Now, you should also know that feeding accounts for more of the bulk of the money in the catfish farm process. So feeding account for cost much of the money. For an existing farmer, you are not building a new pond, you are not maybe buying nets, you are just getting your fingerlings or your juveniles and the feed, and maybe other logistic costs which are not that much. So for a new farmer, you are building your pond, but in today's video we are just looking at the costs of feeding and your estimated profit. Now the other expenditures you are doing are just once for a lifetime expenditure, like the building of the pond, the buying of nets. You don't buy it always, but for feeding, at any time you have juveniles or anytime you want to start up, you must buy feed for them. So we are looking at the cost of the feeding. So let's do a table to show okay. Now the first thing you are looking at the size of the feed. Like I said earlier, each of the fishes has their different sizes. Now the bags, how many bags are you feeding them? Bags. Then the cage, how many kg are they taking? Also, we'll look at the price per bag, and we'll look at the total cost. We'll take this off. Okay, now the first one, which is a 1.5 mm. Now they won't take up to one bag at this stage, so what they are taking is 3 kg of this. 3 kg. Now the cost per kg for this, the cost per kg for this is 1,007. And note please that the price or the figures you are going to be using in this video might differ in your area, and also it might differ maybe in the next 2 to 3 months because of the inflation price and the changing of prices of the goods and services within our country. So the total cost for the 3 kg will be 5,100. Now we look at the 2 mm. For the 2 mm, we are feeding them a total of 2 bags. Now at this stage they don't eat much, so that can go. Then for the kg, 30 kg, note a bag contains 15 kg, and the total cost The cost per bag is 11.5. Now, this might differ from the type of feed you are making use of, the price. You might have some that are cheaper, you might have some that are higher than this price for the feed, but at this stage, your fishes need a feed that has high protein content. So look at a feed that has very high protein content. Well, this is the early stage of their life. So that, and fish feed that have high protein content helps for stability of growth, faster growth, and regular growth also. So for the 2 bags, it will cost us 23,000. Then for the 3 mm, we are feeding 4 bags. And this is 50 kg, and per bag we have is 10,500, and the total cost will be 42,000. Then we'll look at the 4 mm. The 4 mm is 11 bags. At this stage, they are still eating much. And we have a total of 165 kg. Now watch, there's a progression in their eating. At the early stage, it was just 3 kg. They will graduate to 2, 4, now 11 bags. So, and this will give us 10,500, and the total cost is 115,500. Then you look at your 6 mm. Now, once you get to the stage of the 6 mm, you can now switch to maybe still quality feed, but maybe the quality feed maybe from a different company. Because at this stage, they still eat, but they are done. They is just to stabilize their growth. So at this stage, you can switch from most of the foreign feed, so maybe good Nigerian feed that still has good protein content and that can still enable the growth of the fishes. So you're looking at 20 bags for this. 20 bags. And the 20 bags will give us a total sum of 300 kg. And per bag of 6,000, which gives us a sum of 120,000. And the last one, which is a 9 mm, they'll be taking 30 bags of this, which is a total of 450 kg. The eating progression grows per time, and the cost per bag is 5,500, which will give us a total of 165,000 naira. Now this is for the individual feeding and the cost. Yeah, let's look at the total kg. Now if you calculate the total kg that the fishes have taken for the period of, and this is a period of 4 months and 2 weeks, they will take this for 4 months and 2 weeks, and they are set for harvest. So we are having a total of 1,008 kg total. The total kg will give us 1,008 kg. Then for the price, now the price will be 470,600. So now this is the total cost you spend for the 1,000 juvenile to train them for 4 months and 2 weeks. And at this stage, we have an average of 1.4 kg. An average of 1.4 kg. Now bear in mind, the 1,000 might not survive, But this is a kg you should be having, an average of 1.4 kg. Some might be far above that, some might be less than that, but on the average you should be getting 1.4 kg. Then let's look at the cost of buying the juvenile. The cost of the juvenile. Now the price of the juvenile might differ within your area, but at 25 naira per one, at 25 naira per one, it will be equal to 20 per one, it will give us a total of 25,000 for the juvenile. Now, like I said earlier, most of the expenditures we are doing for just the feeding, the pond preparation. So most of the bulk of the money lies on feeding and getting your juvenile and maybe other logistics. So the next one we are looking at is now we are seeing the cost of getting the juvenile. So your total cost would be 25,000, which is the cost of the juvenile, plus 470,600, and now this will give us a total cost of 495,600. So getting your juvenile and training the 1,000 fishes for 4 months, this is the amount you are going to be spending. Then now let's look at our estimated sales that you make. Now the fish we sell per kg, and I'm going to be working with 750 naira for per kg. Now in some areas this differs also, and differs in the size. For the roasting size it might be way cheaper, it might be higher. So we are working with 750 per kg. You can sell above this price, and like I said, the figures we are giving out might change over time. So but bear in mind, this is a guide that can, if you follow this guide, no matter the cost at that time, your profit margin should be within the percentage you are going to be getting from this video. So we are doing 750 times your total kg, which is 1,008 kg. Like I said, the amount of feed is equivalent to the weight of your fish. The amount of feed you give them, if you can take note on the amount of feed you give your fishes, it will surely reflect in their weight. So once you know the amount of feed you are giving to them, just bear in mind that this will reflect in their weight. So once we do the calculation for the 750 times the 1,080 kg, we'll be having an estimated sale of 756,000 naira. Now this is your estimated sale, and bear in mind this is not your profit, this is just your estimated sale. So now let's look at your estimated profit margin will be equals to 756,000 minus 495,600, which will give us over 260,000. So your estimated 260,400. Now this is your estimated profit. Now this is your estimated profit for your sales. And let's look at the percentage. the percentage, because for someone who's okay, I don't want to work with 1,000 fishes, I want to work with, let's say, 500, 400, we can get the estimated percentage. Now your percentage, your profit percentage, the profit percentage your profit percentage now will give us you check out the profit 495,600. Now you have a profit percentage of 52%. So 52% of your capital is the profit. So now this is a percentage for someone doing lesser or someone doing higher. But also note that the higher your fishes, the more profit you make. The higher your fishes, the more profit you make from the business. So this is a very good percentage level of 52% in 4 months and 2 weeks. So note, if you are venturing into the business and you want to invest, you should bear in mind you should be having the range of 52% more. Some farmers can even get more from this. Now, if you find a way of maybe producing your feed or reducing the cost of feeding, you can now see that you can make an extra more percentage in your fishes. You can make more profit from the sales if you reduce the cost of the feeding. Now, if you can devise other means of getting your feed, your profit margin can now increase. So, but for this is the estimated percentage for the catfish business. So stay tuned to the Catfish Enterprise channel. We're going to be dropping more videos on related topics around the catfish farm business. Until next time, stay blessed and have a wonderful day.